Hello students, welcome to Alpha Online Education. Today our topic name is Direct Speech and Indirect Speech. Our topic name is Direct Speech and Indirect Speech. Indirect Speech also called Reported Speech. What is the comparison? Direct Speech and Indirect Speech. It is the 11th question in our first year English grammar. Direct speech and indirect speech is the 11th question in our first year English grammar. Okay, students. There are two main ways of reporting. There are two main ways of the words reporting. What are they? Direct speech and indirect speech. Direct speech and indirect speech. Speech is two types. What are they? Direct speech and indirect speech. What is direct speech and what is indirect speech? See here. Direct speech. If the actual words of the speaker are quoted as it is using inverted commas, is called direct speech. Okay? What is indirect speech? If the words of the speaker are changed without changing the meaning of his or her words, and without using inverted commas are called direct speech. Okay? What is direct speech? Direct speech means the words of the speaker, the words, actual words of the speaker, using as it is, without changing the meaning, without changing the words, are called direct speech. What is indirect speech? The actual words of the speaker changing the words. Here, see, observe, changing the words only, not meaning. Changing the words and without changing the meaning is called indirect speech. That is, direct speech and then, okay, vyakti cheppinatundi matalu as it is anithe direct speech. Indirect speech anedi ఒక వ్యక్తి చెప్పిన యొక్క మాటలని కొద్దిగా మార్చు, అంటే ఆ యొక్క మాటలు మాత్రమే మార్చు, మీనింగ్ మార్చకుండా చెప్పినట్లయితే దాన్ని ఇండైరెక్ట్ స్పీచ్ అంటాం. నెక్స్ట్, డైరెక్ట్ స్పీచ్ లో వి యూజ్ ఇన్వర్టెడ్ కామాస్. ఇన్ ద ఇండైరెక్ట్ స్పీచ్ వి డు నాట్ యూజ్ ఇన్వర్టెడ్ కామాస్. వితౌట్ యూజింగ్ ఇన్వర్టెడ్ కామాస్ ఇస్ కాల్డ్ ఇండైరెక్ట్ స్పీచ్. డైరెక్ట్ స్పీచ్ అనేది ఇన్వర్టెడ్ కామాస్ యూజ్ చేసి చెప్పడం జరుగుతుంది. ఇండైరెక్ట్ స్పీచ్ లో ఇన్వర్టెడ్ కామాస్ రావచ్చు, కొటేషన్ మార్క్స్, కొటేషన్ మార్క్స్ యూజ్ చేసి చెప్తారు, కొటేషన్ మార్క్స్ లేకుండా చెప్పడం జరుగుతుంది. అంటే వాట్ ఇస్ దట్ స్పీచ్? ద యాక్చువల్ వర్డ్స్ ఆఫ్ ద స్పీకర్ యాజ్ ఇట్ ఇస్ కాల్డ్ దట్ స్పీచ్. వాట్ ఇస్ ద స్పీచ్? ద యాక్చువల్ వర్డ్స్ ఆఫ్ ద స్పీకర్ చేంజింగ్ ద వర్డ్స్ అండ్ వితౌట్ చేంజింగ్ ద మీనింగ్ ఇస్ కాల్డ్ ఇండైరెక్ట్ స్పీచ్. Understand? See the example. He said, I have many problems. He said, I have many problems. Here, use quotation marks. Quotation marks. Inverted commas. Quotation marks also called inverted commas. Here, use inverted commas. Inverted commas from the government. It is a direct speech. Next, he said that he had many problems. He said that he had many problems. Here, there are no inverted commas. That's why it is called indirect speech. Direct speech of the problem. Inverted commas meant the direct speech will come. Inverted commas meant the indirect speech will come. So, but if a direct speech of, if a sentence will come, indirect speech will come. He said, I have many problems. Then, after that, I have many problems. change the sentence into index speech. In the examination, you will be asked like that. Students, in the 11th question, you will be asked 6 questions. 2 questions for your choice. Okay? 6 questions will be asked from the 4 topics. From 4 grammar topics. What are they? Activized past tense, direct indirect speech, degrees of comparison, and question type. In these 4 topics, you will be asked 6 questions. Okay? For these 6 questions, you need to write only 4 questions. 2 questions for your chance. So, in the indirect speech, in the direct speech and indirect speech, you will be asked at least 1 or 2 questions. You will be asked at least 1 or 2 questions. In the examination, you will be asked, you will be get 1 mark. In the examination, if you ask 2 questions, you will be get 2 marks. Okay? Each question carries 1 mark. For the students, example, he said, I have many problems. I have many problems. So change the sentence into indirect speech. How to change a sentence from direct to indirect speech? There are few rules. First, see the answer. Later, we will discuss rules. He said, I have many problems. Question. Answer, he said that he had many problems. First, carefully observe the question. What is the question asked here? What is the tense of the question? Okay? Observe. He said, this is called a reporting workbook. Reporting workbook. This is called reporting workbook. Okay? Next one. The quotation mark sentence is called reporting speech. Reporting speech. Outside of the quotation marks is called reporting verb. Inside of the quotation marks is called reporting speech. Okay? Okay, reporting verb is called jagata. What is the tense of the reporting speech? Reporting verb. What is the tense of the reporting verb? He said subject to verb. The verb is in past tense. Reporting verb is in past tense. Okay? Next one. This is subject to, helping verb to, object to. Here you can say only, I have many problems. I have many problems. The sentence is in present perfect tense. Here you should know, have helping verb to. Okay? That's why it is called the present perfect tense. Okay? Change the sentence into indirect speech. First in general, the reporting verb is in past tense. Then the reporting speech will be changed into corresponding past tense. Reporting verb past tense ante ikkada reporting speech kuda indirect speech lo marchinappudu daniki anugunanga undatundi past tense lo marchali. Mari the tense of the reporting speech is present perfect. So manadu emaindante daniki equal lo unna past tense ante past perfect lo marchali. Next two, he said Rasha. Next two, comma, inverted commas removed. Comma and inverted commas are omitted. Omitted means removed. Next two, use conjunction that. Use the conjunction that is very very important. That and conjunction in UJR. Okay? Next two, any single comma, inverted commas species. నెక్స్ట్ ప్రొనౌన్స్ కూడా ఇక్కడ స్పీకర్ అండ్ లిజనర్ కనుగొనడం ప్రొనౌన్స్ మాత్రం. దీన్ని మీనింగ్ మార్చకుండా ఓన్లీ పదాలను మార్చుకోవాలి. హీ సెడ్ ఐ హావ్ మెనీ ప్రాబ్లమ్స్. అతను చెప్పాడు నాకు చాలా సమస్యలు. దీన్ని మీనింగ్ మార్చుకునే అతను చెప్పాడు అతనికి చాలా సమస్యలు. ప్రెజెంట్ పర్ఫెక్ట్ లో హ్యావ్ ఉంది దానికి అనుగుణంగా పాస్ట్ పర్ఫెక్ట్ లో కావాలంటే యాడ్ చేస్తాం హ్యావ్ ప్లస్ లో యాడ్ చేస్తాం నెక్స్ట్ మెనీ ప్రాబ్లమ్స్ యాజ్ ఇట్ ఇస్ ఓకే మెనీ ప్రాబ్లమ్స్ అంటే యాజ్ ఇట్ ఇస్ ఆబ్జెక్ట్ అంటే యాజ్ ఇట్ ఇస్ వాట్ ఇస్ ఆన్సర్ హి సెడ్ దట్ హి హ్యావ్ మెనీ ప్రాబ్లమ్స్ నెక్స్ట్ ఇస్ ది అదర్ ఎగ్జాంపుల్ షి సెడ్ I was watering the plants in the garden. She said, I was watering the plants in the garden. First, see the reporting verb. The reporting verb is in past tense. When the reporting verb is in past tense in the direct speech, in the indirect speech, the tense of the reported speech changed. According to the equal past tense. Okay? Then the agency of the other game, another one at 20, equal past tense of past tense. Okay? First, where to get the past tense? Comma, you can come on the correct answer. She said, reporting will be in past tense. So, she said, next, comma, you can come on the remove and use conjunction that. Okay? I was watering the plants in the garden. What is the tense of the reporting speech? I was watering. Here everyone was watering even the simple before. What is the tense of the reporting speech? It is in past continuous tense. The tense is past continuous tense. Okay? The past continuous tense is changed into the indirect speech, past perfect continuous tense. What? Past perfect continuous tense. Next, pronouns also change according to the listener and the speaker. So, I was watering the plants in the garden. What is the meaning of the sentence? Nenu garden lo plants ku neelu pettutu undenu. So, in the indirect meaning is aame garden లో plants కు వాటర్ పెడుతూ ఉండేది నీళ్ళు పెడుతూ ఉండేది అనుకోవాలి ఆమె తర్వాత సో ఐ ప్లస్ లో షీ అనుకోవాలి నెక్స్ట్ పాస్ట్ కంటిన్యూస్ బికమ్స్ పాస్ట్ పర్ఫెక్ట్ కంటిన్యూస్ పాస్ట్ పర్ఫెక్ట్ కంటిన్యూస్ మీన్స్ హ్యాడ్ బీన్ ప్లస్ బిఫోర్ ఆర్ ఓకే సిద్ధార్థ షీ సెడ్ దట్ అండ్ కామా అండ్ ఇవన్న కామా రిమూవ్ యూజ్ ఉంటాయి నెక్స్ట్ షీ హ్యాడ్ బీన్ వాటరింగ్ ద ప్లాంట్స్ had been watering the plants in the garden. This is the answer. Okay? Next one. See the rules. After learning the rules, we shall practice the questions. We shall practice the questions according to statements, next imperative sentences, interrogative sentences, and exclamative sentences. So, first rules. What is the first one? A suitable reporting verb like said or asked or replied or requested or exclaimed etc. is used depending on the type of reported clause whether the clause is in statement, imperative, interrogative and exclamative. Understand? And then first is the start of reporting verb to start of it. Reporting verb on the end of said gaane, asked gaane, replied, requested, exclaimed. Is it? And then, we use the derivative of the reported class, derivative class of the sentence. Statement, imperative, interrogative, exclamative, and then we have the derivative. Okay? Next one. Okay, now. Inverted commas in the statement, inverted commas in the sentence and the question is if play the whether not. Okay? If play the whether not the connection of the reporting verb and the other one. Ask. Okay? Next one. Okay, now. Exclamation sentence is exclaimed the mark. like the or if or whether is yours. Next switch from comma inverted comma से तीसरे चरण next switch आ चुका. तीसरे चरण आ गए conjunction. तब तक आ रहे conjunction आ रहे if का नहीं whether का नहीं is यार if का नहीं whether का नहीं only questions के मेरे का सवाल पालो दक्षिण conjunction वाला. Next all pronouns are changed according to the speaker and the listener. Because I got it, she got it, he got pronounced under the martha. Allah, according to the speaker and the listener. But the grammar pronounced in the change. Next, fourth, when the reporting verb is in the present tense, or future tense, or universal pronoun, the tense will not be changed in the indirect speech. Understand? Reporting speech, ఇవ్వబడుతుంటే డైరెక్ట్ స్పీచ్ లో రిపోర్టింగ్ వర్బ్ అనేది ప్రెసెంట్ టెన్స్ లో గాని ఫ్యూచర్ టెన్స్ లో గాని ఉన్నట్లయితే ఇండైరెక్ట్ స్పీచ్ లో మారినప్పుడు రిపోర్టింగ్ క్లాజ్ యొక్క టెన్స్ అనేది మారడం జరుగుతుంది. ఏ టెన్స్ లో ఉంటుంది అది టెన్స్. నెక్స్ట్ యూనివర్సల్ కూడా కానీ అది కూడా ఇండైరెక్ట్ స్పీచ్ లో యాజ్ ఇట్ ఇస్ ఉంటుంది. సార్ రిపోర్టింగ్ వర్బ్ అనేది ప్రెసెంట్ టెన్స్ లో కానీ ఫ్యూచర్ టెన్స్ లో కానీ ఉన్నట్లయితే టెన్స్ మార్చడం జరగదు. యూనివర్సల్ ప్రింటిస్తో ఒకవేళ యూనివర్సల్ ప్రింట్ అనేది దస్తాను ప్రయాస ఆర్డర్ కూడా దస్తాను ప్రయాస ఇండైరెక్ట్ స్పీచ్ టెన్స్ అనేది మారుతుంది. నెక్స్ట్ ఇట్స్ వెరీ వెరీ ఇంపార్టెంట్ ఫిఫ్త్ రూల్ వెన్ ద రిపోర్టింగ్ వర్బ్ ఇస్ ఇన్ ప్రెసెంట్ టెన్స్ ద టెన్స్ చేంజ్డ్ ఇన్ ద ఇండైరెక్ట్ స్పీచ్ యాజ్ ఫాలో. ఇదే రిపోర్టింగ్ వర్బ్ అనేది పాస్ట్ టెన్స్ లో ఉన్నట్లయితే అంటే స్టడీ గాని ఆస్పిడ్ గాని ఉన్నట్లయితే మనకు ఇండైరెక్ట్ స్పీచ్ లో మార్చేటప్పుడు దానికి టెన్స్ అనేది కింద జరిపిన విధంగా చెప్తారు టెన్స్ మారడం జరుగుతుంది. ఇట్ ఇస్ వెరీ వెరీ ఇంపార్టెంట్ ఇట్ ఈస్ వెరీ వెరీ ఇంపార్టెంట్ వాట్ ఇస్ ద రిపోర్టింగ్ వర్బ్ ఇన్ ద ప్రెసెంట్ టెన్స్ the tense changed in the indirect speech as follows. Okay, tense changed as follows from direct to indirect speech. The reporting verb is past tense in the direct speech. In the direct speech the tense changed as follows. It is very very important. Okay, in the direct speech if the given sentence is simple present tense, it becomes in the indirect speech simple past tense. Simple present tense becomes, it's equal to past tense form, simple past tense form. Simple present tense, what is the structure of simple present tense? V1, subject plus V1 plus object. In the simple past tense, subject plus V2 plus object. Verb is very very important, subject objects are common. Okay? Next, present continuous tense becomes past continuous tense. What are the verbs used in the present continuous tense? Am is the helping verbs, V4 is main verb. That becomes was verb plus V4. Was verb are the helping verbs in the past continuous tense. Main tense, main verb is V4 means V1 plus inform. Next, present perfect tense. What are the helping verbs in the present perfect tense? As, have. Main verb to V3. Becomes in the past perfect tense. Had plus V3. Present perfect tense becomes past perfect tense in the indirect speech. Okay? As, have, helping verbs becomes had. Here also main verb V3, here also main verb V3. Next, present perfect continuous tense becomes as the past perfect continuous tense. What is the structure of present perfect tense? Present perfect continuous tense, subject plus has or have plus be plus before plus object. In the past perfect continuous tense, subject plus have been plus before. Okay, next simple past tense becomes the past perfect tense. Simple past tense means will is the never. There are no have becomes in the simple past tense. So it becomes past perfect tense means had plus did. Next one, past continuous tense becomes past perfect continuous tense. Past continuous tense becomes past perfect continuous tense. Past, how do you identify past continuous tense? With the help of helping verb, 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 main verb, will form. Past perfect continuous tense, had been plus will form. Have been helping verb, will form, main verb. Next one, past perfect tense becomes past perfect tense. Past perfect tense remains as the same past perfect tense. What is the structure of past perfect tense? At this DT, at plus DT. Here also, at plus DT, same remains. Next, past perfect continuous tense. It remains same past perfect continuous tense. Structure of the past perfect continuous tense has been plus understand? Simple present tense. Simple present tense. In the simple present tense, there are no helping verbs. Not a name of this given. Simple present tense becomes simple past tense. We do. Simple present tense. Simple past tense. Present continuous tense becomes a past continuous tense. Present perfect tense becomes a past perfect tense. Present perfect continuous tense becomes a past perfect continuous tense. Simple past tense becomes a past perfect tense. Past continuous tense becomes a past perfect continuous tense. Past perfect to past perfect tense becomes a past perfect tense. Past perfect continuous tense becomes a same past perfect continuous tense. It is very 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 important table. Understand? Next, helping verbs. Some modal helping verbs and their changes. Will. In the indirect speech, will becomes the direct speech, would. Will becomes would. Will plus given, would plus given becomes. Next, shall plus given becomes should plus given. Can plus given becomes could plus given. Next, may plus given becomes might plus given. Next, would plus given becomes same, would plus given. Should plus given remains same, should plus given. Could plus given also remains same, could plus given. Might plus given remains same, might plus given. Must plus given becomes had to plus given. It is very very important. Okay? These are the tense changes from the direct speech to indirect speech. Okay? Simple present tense becomes simple past tense. Present continuous tense becomes past continuous tense. Present perfect tense becomes past perfect tense. Okay? Present perfect continuous tense becomes past perfect continuous tense. Simple past tense becomes past perfect tense. Okay? Next, past continuous tense becomes past perfect continuous tense. Next, past perfect remains past perfect. Past perfect continuous tense remains past perfect continuous tense. Will becomes would, can becomes could, shall becomes should, may becomes might. Next, would, should, could, might remains as the same. Next, must plus even becomes had to plus even. Okay, thank you students. The remaining part, the words expressing nearness in place or time are changed from direct speech to indirect speech as follows. The words expressing nearness in place or the time are changed from direct speech to indirect speech as follows. Okay? In the direct speech, this becomes in the indirect speech that. This becomes that. These becomes those. Here becomes there. Now becomes then. Does becomes in that way. Okay? Next one. Ago becomes before. Today becomes that day. Tonight becomes that night. Understand? Tomorrow becomes the next day. Tomorrow becomes the next day. Next one. Yesterday becomes the previous day or the day before. Yesterday becomes the previous day or the day before. Next one. Hereby becomes thereby. Either becomes neither. Hence becomes thence. Henceforward becomes thenceforward. Last night becomes the previous night or the night before. Next one. Next week becomes the following week. Next week becomes the following week. The following week. Last night becomes the previous night or the night before. These are the changes from direct speech to indirect speech. Okay, students, please remember them. These are very, very important. From direct speech and indirect speech.